subject is unresponsive again. I'll be with you in just a moment. I am just finishing my notes on yet another failed attempt at the cure. I do wish that the foundation that my fellow colleagues would provide me with something other than bovines, various mammals, lesser beings. This is just not working out for me. Okay. Perhaps one day they will to their senses and realize that my meager and simple request for a human subject is not all that very irrational. What is this? That day has finally arrived. Do not jape with me. I am in no mood for japing. Actually, I do not enjoy japing anymore. A good jest from time to time, yes. But japing is such, so passe. So please, enlighten me with what you speak. So, you have willingly elected to volunteer to be my first true human subject. Is that so? You are not a member of the medical staff, are you? I do not recognize you. Who sent you? Was it Dr. Sherman, perhaps? Or was it surely it was not Dr. Ham. No, it was not. Well, if what you say is true, And you are very well aware of what I do of my work. Then I guess you are right. Today is the day that I finally get to work on a true human specimen. And yes, I can sense the pestilence on you. You will make for a prime specimen. Well then, this is a cause for a celebration, is it not? Would you care for some crackers, cheese, and salted pork? Just a moment. Allow me to set aside my notes. Might I offer you something to drink? No? That is fine. Oh, and by the way, earlier when I mentioned the late Dr. Ham, well, Dr. Ham, meet my very first human subject, and please, your name? Meet Dr. Ham. Yes. I do like to keep this as a token. My good late colleague and friend. You may have seen the report. I tried to speak sense to the doctor, but he would not listen, as none of them do. Yes. Hello. Yes, of course they would be recording this. And of course I am sure they will come and confiscate Dr. Ham's skull. I do not think they were aware that I was holding it in my possession. But if only Dr. Ham listened to me instead of agitating me and aggravating me and japing with me. I was in no mood for japing that day. And Dr. Ham tried to jape with me. Surely by now you know not to jape with SCP-049, as they refer to me as. Well, I think that is enough of the introductions. Thank you, Dr. Ham. Well, this is such a momentous occasion. My very first human subject, willing subject, who has yet to aggravate me or jape with me. Well, where should I begin? as I mentioned earlier, do you mind? I'm just going to reach out. Yes. I can sense you are severely stricken with the pestilence. The great dying. I believe I can cure you. I'm sure you are familiar with my work. There will be some dissection involved. Some intense exploratory surgery. And then at the end, you will be reborn new and whole, cured of the pestilence. You will be reanimated. But before all of that takes place, I will be putting you asleep. I do not work on my subjects while they are still alive. That would be cruel and unusual. I do have a code of ethics that I live up to, despite what you may hear. So allow me a moment to calm your mind so that I can get your mind into a very responsive and open state. I cannot have you in a very stressful state. So I have a few methods, unorthodox methods, that I think you will find very beneficial. Begun to experiment with sound and the properties, the calming, soothing properties of sound of various objects and how they cause the human mind and the animal mind as well to reach a very euphoric state. I have found this very fortuitous in aiding the pre-op work that I do to prepare the subject for the surgery and removal of the pestilence. Take, for instance, these medical gloves and the sounds that they make. They create a very pleasing sound. Wouldn't you agree? And so, I have taken it upon myself to use these for more than just protecting my delicate hands. But that is enough jibber jabber. Let me get my notebook. Just a moment. What was your name again, please? And your nationality, your heritage, your bloodline. And your age. So you were born in, okay. Let me look at your eye color. Hair color. And your height, what is your exact height? You look to be about, yes, I was just going to say that. And your weight. Okay. Are you currently taking any medications? Okay. Do you have any ailments or a certain disease that may run in your genes? I see. All of this is very important. It helps me determine how to treat and remove the pestilence. What may work for you, it may not work for another. And how have you been feeling overall, being that you are stricken by the pestilence? Do you find that it impairs your everyday life? Again, I think that will be enough. Just a moment. I would like you to meet another friend of mine. In my possession for so many centuries. Although it would be nice to have a new one, it is beginning to get on in its years. Are you familiar with this bag of mine? Limitless in its capacity to hold whatever you may put within. But I have not even yet to have begun to explore its fathomless depths. Now you see. I did not create this bag. I happened to acquire this bag from a particular individual selling quite peculiar trinkets and totems. In this bag, I was told, once belonged to a doctor even greater than I, although his line of work was not in dealing with the great pestilence. Now, actually, I believe he was a she. If I'm not mistaken, age has not been very good to me. Yes, she was a doctor. A podiatrist, I believe. Yes. Why a podiatrist would need an infinite bag of holding, I do not know. But it is not mine to question the business of others. Well, let us get on with it, shall we? I know I have prattled on for far too long. Now, if you will please stare straight ahead at my finger, I just want to examine your eyes for signs of the pestilence. Clearly, I can see it. Please continue to stare straight at my finger. Your pupils respond just as any other humans. But I'm just going to hold your eye open a little bit. Yes. The pestilence is squirming all around your iris. And let me check this one again. Yes. Now, I just want you to follow the light as it slowly moves in your field of view. This is part of what they call a cranial nerve exam. This is just a simple little test to see how your nervous system is responding to various stimuli. Yes, very good. Just continue to follow the light. That's it. You are quite the perfect subject, I must say. Very good. Just one more time. Keep following the light. Very good. Do you find yourself to be in a more relaxed state than when you first arrived and witnessed me completing the failed curing of that animal? You are very good. Okay, very good. Just a moment. I want to listen to your vitals. Just take a listen to your heart. Yes, it is beating very strong. This is very good. I'm not going to bother with taking your pulse. Such modern methods are not necessary for this procedure. I can hear well enough how healthy you are. And now let me listen to your lungs. Would you mind breathing in deeply? And exhale. Again. And exhale. Very good. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Again. Inhale. And exhale. Well, you are indeed quite the perfect specimen. Just a moment. Are you afraid of needles? Well, very well. I was going to give you a pre-operative dose of a very special tincture of my own devising, but I will do that once you have fallen asleep and I begin with the procedure to remove the pestilence from you, to cure you. Are you afraid of scalpels? Okay, well, I will be using this very clean scalpel to make some incisions to begin the dissection and the surgery that will remove the pestilence from you. But not now. I just wanted you to become familiar with one of the tools that I will be using. But do not worry. As I said, you will not even be awake or aware of the surgery that I will be performing on you. I did also want to show this off, as it is my prized scalpel. I have been using it on countless subjects. It has served me well, and served them well to a degree. While I have not been able to cure any subject just yet, perhaps you will be the first. Yes. A moment. This is the pestle and mortar that I use. That is currently filled with a special ingredient which goes into the tincture that I use. And my subjects, I like to think of it as the remedy, the cure for the pestilence, perhaps the reason that I have not been successful. Curing the pestilence in any of my subjects is because this formula is not perfect, needs some fine tuning. As I was mentioning earlier, as part of the pre-op routine, SCP-049 simply wants to help you to relax. And you are very relaxed now, aren't you? That is just something magnificent. About these sounds. Find them quite calming and soothing to my own mind. Feel yourself beginning to get very sleepy. Yes. Excellent. I may not need to administer a pre-op sedative. If I'm able to put you to sleep, into a very deep sleep, then I may just be able to begin the surgery without need of any medications that will numb your nervous system. But I will do it as a matter of precaution. As no matter how of a deep sleep you may find yourself in, your pain receptors are still very well awake and alert, so they will need to be subdued and quieted, so that you do not wake up in the middle of surgery, screaming out in pain, and being a disruption to my important work. Can't have it. Just a moment. About some calming hand motions, courtesy of my late colleague, Dr. Ham. Dr. Ham's hands, if you will. Yes. I suspect that the Foundation will not be too keen on knowing that I have both Dr. Ham's skull and his hands in my possession. As well as his eyes, his right femur, kidney, gallbladder, heart, brain. But enough of that. Let us get your mind into a very deep state of relaxation, and then SCP-049 will begin to cure you of that which plagues you. Soon, you will be cured. I just feel it. You will be my first true human subject, and successful one at that. Do you like Dr. Ham's hands? Do you find them to be very calming to your mind? Good. And have you noticed how well manicured they are? Credit for that, even in their post-mortem state. I have been able to keep them in a very healthy state. just as they were when Dr. Ham last used them. There. How do you feel now? Very relaxed. Are you ready to fall asleep? It looks like you may have already. You seem to be just staring off into space. Well, I believe I will finish with one more technique, and it will be time to begin to cure you. Just a moment while I put Dr. Ham's hands away. I know that the Foundation is oh so very full of themselves and proud of all the different anomalies that they so greedily keep locked up here against their own will. Did you ever think about that? Have you ever placed yourself in the shoes of one of the other anomalies? Do you think the Foundation is as morally just in what they do, keeping the world supposedly safe from individuals and entities like myself who only want to save the world from things that will cause them harm? Maybe it is the Foundation that has brainwashed everyone into believing that they are doing greater good. Just think about that. Us anomalies are people too. Even though some of us are rocks and doors and toasters, you get the picture. As you can see and hear, I have some of my own anomalies that have yet to be documented by the Foundation, such as these blocks. Ornately carved. Are you familiar with any of these symbols? No, I did not create them. But they do have a very peculiar set of powers, anomalous. Energy. There is a certain language written on these that is beyond my comprehension. But I have begun to study the glyphs written upon them. And these symbols seem to reference an entity from another dimension or universe by the name of Cthulhu. Are you familiar? Do you see you seem to acknowledge the existence of that name? Perhaps one day I will unlock the mystery of these ancient wooden blocks. But until then, just listen to the pleasing sounds that they make. Now it is time for you to sleep. And when you wake up, you will find yourself to be cured. The great dying, the pestilence that stricken everyone. Now it's time to sleep. Soon all of your worries will be over. Soon you will be cured, and the world will know of my work and the foundation will be held accountable. Oh, and before you drift off completely, it would be great if you could somehow get me out of here. I have had enough of this place. I wish there was some kind of containment breach or something of the like that would cause the doors to open. And I could be set free with all of my other anomalous friends, that we are all being held hostage here against our will. Now we can discuss that once I have cured you. Time to sleep. Time to sleep. Everything is going to be all right. No more pestilence for you. And then I will reanimate your corpse. And while the reanimation procedure is a little bit iffy and sketchy, I will admit, you will lose some of your memories and functions. You will still have about 65 to 70% of your humanity. But we can discuss all of that once I have cured you and once the procedure is over. Sleep, my friend. Sleep and dream of a new beginning. And how wondrous it will be to finally be cured and free of the pestilence. Shall begin with a small incision right. Oh, you are awake. Okay, just a moment. Looks like I'm going to need to administer a sedative after all. Close your eyes. Back to sleep you go. Back.